Don't you think that one of the reasons why President Trump has been able to appeal to the blue-collar workers that you talk about is because of his message on trade? And that message is Washington, D.C. and Wall Street have sold you out. The trade deals have been about helping them, helping their bottom line, helping politicians, but not about you. And he pointed to NAFTA, which you supported. He pointed to most favored nation status for China, which you supported. There are other factors too, of course, automation. But the idea, the pitch that too many of these trade deals screwed you.
And then look what he did. Look what his tax cut did. The multi-billion dollar, trillion dollar tax cut that went mainly to the very wealthy and to corporate America. What did it do? They got a reward for offshoring jobs. They got a reward for taking. So you had 7,000 jobs right off the bat go abroad. These are contracts that the federal government gives to contractors to do things for the federal government or for the community. And what happens? They get a break if they go abroad, their taxes get cut. That's why I was out here today talking about two things. One, if you're going to offshore jobs with federal contracts, offshore jobs, you're going to get a 10% penalty for those jobs you send overseas. Because what happens? You send it overseas because it's a supplier that makes the product cheaper. You bring it back, you get a benefit, a tax break for it. And where does it go? It doesn't go to the employees, by the way, even when it occurs. It goes into the pockets of the CEOs and or to buy back their stock, to raise the value of their stock. And so what I'm insisting on, and I'll get it passed, that is a 10% surtax on you if you ship for every job you ship overseas, for anything that comes back. And secondly, making sure that if you invest in America, you refurbish a plant, you build a new plant here, we will provide you a 10% advance on the cost of doing that. Encourage people to come back and build here in America. Because we've had this Buy America provision, America First provision, Buy America, for over almost 100 years. It's never been moved. And now we have the highest trade deficit we've had in modern history.
So you asked, and what did he do after he got elected? And you brought up the tax bill. Something else he did is he renegotiated NAFTA.
He did.
He renegotiated NAFTA. Now, when you ran for president and when Barack Obama ran for president, you both said you would renegotiate NAFTA. You didn't. He did. Nancy Pelosi said that the USMCA, which President Trump signed into law, is a, quote, victory for America's workers. Does he deserve credit for that?
No, I think, remember, he wasn't the one that pushed that particular one that passed. The House amended the bill, so he couldn't.
He signed it.
By the way, it's a big deal, though. Here's what they amended. He was given pharma a way out, giving them a gigantic break, just like he's doing now with pharma. They're building plants overseas and getting tax breaks for it. That's what it was about with him. And they said, no, we're not going to do that.
He renegotiated NAFTA and you didn't, is the point. I mean,
because we had a Republican Congress that wouldn't go along with us renegotiating it.
But doesn't he deserve some credit for that? It's better. The USMCA is better than NAFTA.
It is better than NAFTA. But look what the overall trade policy has done even with NAFTA. We now have this gigantic deficit in trade with Mexico. Not because NAFTA wasn't made better, but because the overall trade policy and how he deals with it made everything worse.
I guess my only point is, I'm a blue-collar guy sitting in Macomb County, Michigan, if I were that person.
Yep.
And I'm sitting here listening to your pitch, and I'm thinking, I like what he has to say, but he's part of the establishment that's been selling my jobs down the river. He supported NAFTA. He supported most favored nation status for China. And Trump did negotiate NAFTA, and Obama and Biden didn't.
Well, I'll tell you what we did do. We inherited the greatest recession short of a depression. The president put me in charge of that to do something about it. In the process of that, I was the one who was given responsibility to make sure General Motors and Chrysler didn't go bankrupt. And so we made sure they didn't, brought 80,000 jobs here to Michigan and to the automobile industry. 80,000 good paying jobs came back. He's lost 50,000 of those jobs since he's been president. The fact of the matter is NAFTA was not the deal that was sold. When Bush said we were going to have enforcement mechanism in NAFTA, they didn't do it. That's why after it passed, and he did not insist on that, I was against NAFTA, and we tried to begin to change it because it didn't keep the deal that was made. There was none of the enforcement mechanism were abandoned. And so, but look, here's what else he's doing. We're talking about trade. What has he done with trade to give, to create more jobs in the United States? What's happened with his trade policy? Look what he's done with China. It's a disgrace. What he's done, he's allowed the corporate America to be able to make money by continuing to export American jobs. It's not made in America. Make it another place. For example, those carry bags that the military is using, they're supposed to be made, they're being deployed, made in America. They're made in China. They're made in China. Doesn't do anything about any of that.